Is Mr. Gerald Davis here? Gerald, can you open up the word of prayer for us?
I don't make a speech. Let's pray. Father, we're grateful to you today for the very mercies that surround us so bountifully. You are gracious and giving God, and for that we give you thanks today. We are conscious of those who are having difficulties, those who have lost loved ones, and those who don't know exactly what to do. And I pray today, God, that you will grant your wisdom and your leadership and guidance. If there are those in this building today who need a special touch from you, I pray, Lord God, that you will walk with them today and grant to them your wisdom in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Gerald. You may be seated.
Over the
songs in some strange settings. What I'm going to sing this morning, I was driving my car to work at about 6 o'clock in the morning and was looking around, observing what was going on. The Lord gave me a song, so I'm driving and writing. It's called To Live For Him. At 6 o'clock in the morning, there's a dew on the ground. The sun shines on the mountaintops. There's a freshness all around. Folks are rising for their morning as a new day starts again. I say thank you for one more day. I will wake again, and that's when His blessings he will bring. His voice comes quickly to me. Be still and know that I am God. I pause right then and I begin to live for him. God created the heavens and the earth. There was darkness upon the earth and it was void. But God separated that darkness with light. The darkness, the day, the light he called day, the darkness he called night. God created all things in the land, in the sea, and in the air. And he said it was good. And then God scooped up dirt from the ground, and he formed man, and he breathed into man's soul. And then God caused a deep sleep to come upon the man, because he saw that the man was lonely. And from his side, he took a rib. In his image, he created man and woman. At 6 o'clock in the evening, the starlight begins to glow. The moon shines through the darkness, and it's times like this I know. God created you and I, that we would serve him well. And Jesus gave his life for us, to save us all from hell. And that's when I feel the presence of my King. While I'm kneeling by my bedside, his blessings he will bring. His voice comes quickly to me. Be still and know that I am God. And I pause right then, and I